FaceTime is an Apple app that allows you to make and receive video calls over a Wi-Fi or mobile data connection. But what many of you may not realize is the quality of these audio calls is often better than the high-definition voice services offered by its rivals, including standard phone calls. And you can now use FaceTime to speak with people outside of the Apple ecosystem. Or to word it another way, people who own an Android device or Windows PC. So if you're one of the millions of people who use FaceTime daily, then watch this video to the end as you may learn something that will help you. Alternatively, if you don't have time to watch all this video, click on one of the chapters below and head straight to the sections you're interested in, including how to maintain natural eye contact during a video call when in fact you're looking at other apps on your device, and how to set up FaceTime calls with Android and Windows users. But first, if you haven't done so already, why not subscribe below? After all, it's free and your support would be astronomically appreciated. Setting up FaceTime. FaceTime is set up the moment you switch on an iPhone with an active SIM in. However, if you do find yourself in the unusual situation where FaceTime isn't working, then on your device, head to Settings, FaceTime, and make sure FaceTime is switched on. With FaceTime set up, you can then set it up on any other Apple device that you own. To do this, grab the device you want to set it up on, and then open Settings, FaceTime, and sign into the same iCloud account on each device you want it on. But what if you don't own an iPhone? Well, FaceTime can be set up on an iPad, Apple Mac, or iPod Touch using an email address that is registered to your iCloud account. To do this, head to Settings, open FaceTime, and sign into your iCloud account, where, if you have more than one email address assigned to your iCloud account, you can choose which one you want to be contacted on. If you have several phone numbers and email addresses assigned to your iCloud account, then the options available to you are quite varied. For example, if you have dual SIM, you can choose which one of the two phone numbers you want to be contacted on, or choose to be contacted on both of them. You can also choose to be contacted through your email address or addresses that are assigned to your iCloud account. And if you own more than one Apple device, you can further tailor this for each device. For example, you might choose to be contacted through your phone number on your iPhone and your email address or addresses on your iPad. There's no perfect setup here, it just depends on what works best for you. How to use FaceTime. FaceTime can be used in one of two ways, video calls or audio calls. You can choose to have a two-way conversation with someone or have a group call with multiple people. Making a FaceTime call can be done in several ways. The most common way is through the FaceTime app. To do this, open the app. Tap on the New FaceTime button. Select or enter the details of the contact you wish to speak with, and then select to have a video or audio call with them. Another way is through the contact list on your device. To do this, open the contact list, select the contact you wish to speak with, and then select how you wish to call them on FaceTime. Alternatively, if you have an existing iMessage conversation with your contact, you can select their profile at the top of the message chat and choose to have a FaceTime call this way. Group calls are achieved in much the same way. If you're using the FaceTime app, then within the app you can add additional people by pressing the plus button and selecting or entering their contact details. Or if you have a group iMessage chat, you can tap on the profile images or bubbles at the top of the group chat and select to have a FaceTime chat this way. How to use FaceTime with non-Apple devices. Now, this is all very well and good if the contact has an Apple device, but how do you speak with people who own an Android device or Windows PC? Well, FaceTime can now be used across different platforms through the creation of a FaceTime link. By clicking the link, owners of other devices can then join a FaceTime call through a web browser. To do this, you will first need to create the link by opening the FaceTime app and tapping Create Link. With the link created, you can then share it through text, WhatsApp, email, or through another service. Once your contact has received the link, they can click on it to join a call. Alternatively, you can schedule a FaceTime call in the future through your Apple Calendar app. To do this, create a calendar event as you would do normally and select FaceTime as your location or video call. Call quality. The quality of FaceTime calls is often better than the high-definition voice services offered by its rivals, including standard phone calls, all thanks to its higher quality codec. You can further improve the quality of the call by selecting one of two microphone modes. Voice isolation minimizes the background noise during a call, and wide spectrum mode allows all noises to be heard. To enable one of these modes, while on a FaceTime call, open a control center on your device. Now, depending on which device you own, this can be done by either swiping diagonally down from the top right corner of your screen or by swiping up from the bottom. With the control center then open, select the mic mode button at the top of the screen and then choose which microphone mode you need. And the quality of audio is just as good in group calls where FaceTime supports spatial audio. Spatial audio is designed to sound like your contacts are in the room with you by making it sound like their voices are coming from the direction their tile is in on your screen, where Apple claim it should make conversation flow more naturally. I'll talk more about tiles in a moment. You can also improve the visual quality of a video call by blurring out the background, bringing more focus to yourself. Again, to do this, open a control center during a FaceTime call. Tap the effects button and then choose to turn on or off portrait mode. Group calls. So how do group calls work? FaceTime allows you to chat with up to 32 people at a time. If you've not used it before, each participant's camera will appear as a tile on your screen, and when someone speaks, their tile will grow larger, giving them more prominence on your screen. Other tiles may vary in size, with smaller tiles representing people who haven't spoken recently, and tiles that can't fit on your screen will appear in a row at the bottom, where you can swipe through the row and tap on a person's camera to make it larger. However, if you would rather see your contacts tiles as a grid, tap the grid button and it will standardize both the size and layout of participants' cameras. And if you want to turn off camera prominence, go to Settings, FaceTime, and then turn off speaking below automatic prominence. Features. So these are the various ways you can set up and use FaceTime on different devices, but what about its features? Well, one of the main features I use is picture-in-picture mode. This reduces the size of the video window during a call and moves it to the corner of your screen, allowing you to see and use other apps on your device. To enable picture-in-picture mode, simply come out of FaceTime. Now, depending on which device you have, this can be done by either swiping up from the bottom of your screen or pressing the home button. You can then resize the window to medium or small by double tapping it or pinching it with two fingers, and you can drag the window to move it to another part of your screen. However, if you would rather hide it entirely, you can swipe the window to the side of your screen, and to reveal it again, simply drag it back out. However, your contact may notice you're looking at other things, so to give the appearance that you're maintaining natural eye contact with them, make sure the eye contact feature is enabled by going to Settings, FaceTime, and enabling eye contact. And no video call would be complete without the option to use a filter, sticker, or the ability to use a Memoji or Animoji, which overlays your head with a fun cartoony character where its head moves with yours and it appears to speak when you speak. Something that can be a lot of fun to use if you're speaking with young family members. To enable a Memoji or Animoji, tap on the star effects icon in the image of yourself and choose which one you want. However, it should be noted that this isn't available on all devices. In the same way, you can also use stickers during a call, or add text, or even add a filter to really change things. You can also take a live photo during a video call. To do this, tap on your contact's image during a FaceTime call and a camera button will appear, allowing you to take a live photo. And when you do take a live photo, both you and your contact will be notified that a photo has been taken. However, if you don't want people taking live photos during a video call, or you find it's not working for you, then head to Settings, FaceTime, and toggle on or off FaceTime Live Photos. And perhaps the biggest feature added to FaceTime is SharePlay. SharePlay allows you and your friends to jump on a FaceTime call and collectively watch the same movie, TV show, listen to the same music, use the same supported apps, or share screens. For example, you can share a TV show or movie through the Disney Plus app. To use SharePlay with a contact or contacts, all devices must have updated to iOS 15.1 or later. And if you're wanting to share content that requires a subscription or paid for movie, then everyone must have paid for that movie or have their own subscription to that service. To use SharePlay during a FaceTime call, tap on the SharePlay button where you can navigate to any app you want to share with your callers. And with the release of iOS 16, it will now show you which apps are supported with SharePlay. Alternatively, if you would rather see a list of these apps now, I've added a link in the description below. But what about yourself? Do you use FaceTime regularly? And if so, what do you like about it? Let me know in the comments below and perhaps we can talk about it. Meanwhile, thank you for watching, and if you like this video, please subscribe below and click the like button. Your support would be greatly appreciated. And then check out these videos. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.